Welcome back again. I'm Charlie, SwordofSurvival.com. Today I'm going to show you another snare that you can use set up to catch game. This one's going to be like a basic slip noose for a rabbit. You can also modify it to catch little birds like quail, things like that. I have one set up already in a makeshift hole that I made up over here, but basically let me show you how to tie off the snare. The loop. I'm using 550 paracord. This is a little big for rabbit, but I'm using this so it's a little bit easier to see. But basically, this trap, you would use the inner cord, the little strands inside the 550 paracord. Okay, that's what you use for the noose material. But basically, since I'm gonna use this, so it's a little bit bigger to see on camera. So basically, do you take one end of the cordage? Loop it over, and then tie a little slip knot, like a half knot like that. You don't have to make it too tight. And basically, you feed, grab you a bundle of the cordage and feed that through that hoop. What that does, it makes a nice little slip knot that will tighten up on itself as it wraps around the animal's head or feet or body, whatever it would catch. Then basically that would be left open in front of the hole, and the other end would be tied off to a nice strong point on the, like a branch of the tree or something like this. So I had this set up over here. I'll show you up close how it operates. Okay, basically this ain't a real rabbit hole. I dug this so that I wouldn't end up getting an opportunity to accidentally catch one. But basically, I have two of these snares set up in this one hole. It gives me a better opportunity whether the animal's gonna go in or come out. And then, as you can follow, each end of the cord there is tied off to a strong branch. There's one, and this one is tied off over here on another branch. So what happens, when the animal comes through, his head, well, you're going to off-center each one of the, here's one loop here, and there's another loop. As you notice, one loop is dangling smaller or longer than the other one, so that if he decides to put his head underneath here, he's caught. If he decides to stick his head through here, he's caught. And basically, if you're not using wire, because you can use wire, snare wire for this also, to make this trap work, but since I'm using the string, the inner cord of the 550 cord there, I use smaller sticks propped up on the sides here so that it'll help hold that open. So basically, as that animal comes through, let's say if he's coming out, his head's through there, and as he's coming out, he's caught. See right here, I'm caught around my wrist. So if he goes in the hole, you may come up this trap and see that everything's on the inside of the hole, so you may want to be careful as you're pulling on the string that you may have something caught, you know. Maybe a rabbit, maybe something bigger or smaller. So be careful as you're pulling that trap out of the hole. Okay, so that's how that's set up. So using two of these gives you a better opportunity to catch whatever goes into the hole or comes out of the hole. So you want to use a hole that has, you know, you look around the hole, you can tell by the tracks that are coming in and out of there. So it gives you a good chance to know if this hole's been used or not. And again, you can use this trap also, like saying if you're coming up to an area where you see a lot of quail track, and you have like little log plants like this, the quail like to walk through here, walk through this area right in here along these little plants and stuff, in between little areas like this of yucca plants. And what you can do, these little areas like that, you can set up a loop dangling from here and tie it off to this branch, you know, tie small enough for a quail to get his head through, and as that quail's walking through that little funnel there, they get their head caught in that little snare. So you can set them up all over the place. They can see out here, there's all kinds of little bushes that have seeds and plants and or flowers that the quail like to munch on, and you can just set up a little snares all over the place, especially if you're camped out overnight and you happen to see quail. Let me go ahead and turn this around so I can... let's say you camped out overnight. There we go. I can see myself now. And you hear quail that evening. So, you know, before you go to bed, set up away from your campsite some of these little smaller snares. And hopefully you get a chance of catching those quail. Or hopefully you set up enough around some rabbit holes that look like they've been utilized, and then next morning you get up, or during that day that you're scavenging for your food, then you go out and check your traps. Never let your keep your traps set up and you're moving camp, you're bugging out. Always deactivate them, take that material with you so that you don't inadvertently catch something that you're not going to eat. You know, no use in wasting life. So this is a very simple trap to make. Anybody can do it, but it does work. I've seen them work before, and it's just another one of those traps in your mind up here that you can keep in order to use in your survival attempts. So hopefully you learned something from this one. Stay prepared, stay alive. I'm Charlie. Come back soon.